The angel called out to Abraham, "Because you obeyed God and were willing to sacrifice your only son, the Lord repeats his promise to you. Your descendants will outnumber the stars in the sky and the grains of sand on the shore. Through you, I will bless all the nations on earth, and from your bloodline, my only son will be born."
Hope is coming for those who walk in spiritual darkness, for you will see a great light. I will give you a son, that all who face certain death may find life through him. He will become a great leader, and will be called wise and marvelous counselor, strong ruler, eternal provider and protector. The Prince of Peace, leading with justice and righteousness, his government will be the last, and his reign will be forever. Tonight, darkness fades.
When the Roman government ordered a census of the people, Mary and Joseph traveled to Bethlehem to register. While they were there, Mary gave birth to a son. She wrapped him in cloth, and because there was no room for them in the inn, she placed the baby in the manger used for feeding hay to the animals.
Night, in the fields outside of Bethlehem, a group of shepherds guarded their flock of sheep. Suddenly, an angel appeared before them, and the sky was filled with brilliant light. "Don't be afraid," said the angel. "I have come to bring you good news. A child, the promised Savior, has been born in Bethlehem. You will find him wrapped in cloth, lying in a manger." The hills echoed with the sound of angels singing glory to God. And then, as suddenly as they had appeared, they were gone. The shepherds left immediately and found the child just as the angel had said.
Oh, Before the world was made, Christ existed. He was with God and was himself God. Out of the darkness, shining as the light of life, he created everything that lives. After the fall, the world was filled with darkness again. So the life-giving light came to the world in human form. Although he was born into the same world that he made, many people saw him as a stranger and rejected him. Those who recognized him then and now receive his light and become God's children. And this is our living hope, that the light of life shines in the darkness. This true light is the one and only light, and all who see it have seen the light of God. No one, no thing, not even the darkness, can extinguish it.
Mother's heart comes stealing as Mary holds a baby boy.
What is this thrill, this new emotion that brings
a teardrop to her face? What is this love from such devotion and light? Darkness of this place, a thrill of hope,
the thrill of hope,
the only light, the angel, the thrill of hope is ours this holy night.
Unfamiliar feeling that in a shepherd's heart appears, the all-pervasive light revealing a sense of wonder and of fear, the sky on fire with glory, a song like none has heard before. A thrill to hear the angel story, the coming of the Lord. What is this unfamiliar feeling that in our weary world tonight?
Thrill of hope, a weary world rejoices. The thrill of hope, the only light. The thrill of hope, oh, hail the angel voices.
The thrill of hope is ours this holy night.
We would invite you to stay as we sing our closing hymn, O Holy Night. Words of Emmanuel. Please sing along.
Oh, Let's give it this continuing Chris Tolliver and all the great things he's done. Want to remind everybody before we leave that we do have a potluck supper this, right after church. So there's many ways to get down there. You can go down the back steps here, go down the elevator, or just follow the smell of chicken, and you'll find your way there. Also, remind everybody that we're going to have the cantata again tomorrow night at 7 o'clock, so I invite you to come and invite your friends. Wednesday night at 5:30, we are going Christmas caroling. So if you would like to come and go visit some of our shut-ins or just go make a joyful noise at some stranger's house, we'd love to have you come join with us. And then on Saturday, we are going to have our Christmas Eve service. That's my favorite service of the entire year. It's going to be at 6 o'clock. It's a wonderful time. And don't forget, tonight, our kids will be sharing the message of Christmas with us at 5:30. So I encourage you to come out and support these wonderful kids. Okay? Let's bow our heads and we'll be dismissed. Dear Heavenly and Gracious Father, Lord, thank you so much for this message of Christmas and for the way the choir has presented it to us this day. Lord, what a wondrous hope we have. Father, we pray that as we leave this place, that we'll leave as your ambassadors of this hope, that we'll go forth and share the good news with others by what we say and by what we do. And Father, as we go and partake of this meal, I pray that you will bless it to the nourishment of our bodies. Lord, be in our conversations, be in our discussions, be in our laughter, and be in our joy. And Father, may your blessing be upon us as we go forth from this place. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. Amen. Awesome, guys.